but then that comes off of the B minus terminal.
Hey guys, I'm here today switching out my 100 amp battery in my battery box right now with my new 135 amp battery from Dakota Lithium. While I'm at it, I wanted to show you the battery meter that I'm using. So the battery meter is called the AiLi. It's A-I-L-I battery meter, and it works for lithium batteries. And basically what it does is it will use a shunt, which is a little piece of brass that you connect your negative to, and your negative flows in and out of it, and that will be able to tell you exactly how many amps you're using, which will tell you how much battery you have left. So here's the battery meter I found on Amazon. This is the exact one I'm using. It's just above 40 bucks. And the one that you're gonna want, it says 8 through 80 volts, which is plenty for anything that we're gonna be doing with it. And then it also says 0 to 100 amps, which that means how many amps you're actually running through it, not the battery capacity. So you could run this on this 135 amp battery just fine. Any other size battery you can run it. You just don't want to put more than 100 amps. The Minn Kota motor in the autopilot, it runs about somewhere around 30 amps at the highest level, so that's plenty for this battery meter. So here's my battery box. Here's the battery meter installed right to the box. As I'll show you in a minute, I do have the shunt attached to the top of the box right here under the lid, but this is what it looks like from the outside, and it works perfect for me. I'm not sure it's going to work for everybody, but when it's under my seat, since I have my seat raised, it lines up perfectly in between these bars, and so I can just kind of duck my head down in between my legs and just look and see it perfectly right there. Alright, so I've already disconnected everything, but let me lift the lid and kind of show you what we have going on underneath. So here's our shunt. It's just bolted into the top. It's got a little plastic piece. You can see here it's clear plastic that's made to mount to something. And that's where I've decided to mount it. So basically how you install this shunt is you're going to take your negative that would... For the autopilot that's built into the battery box, it would normally just go straight to your negative terminal, but you're going to connect it to the P minus terminal of the shunt. Then you're going to make a new wire. You got to use the same gauge or bigger, but then that comes off of the B minus terminal and goes straight to the battery. So after you get that set up, you have a power that will need to connect, and I don't know if I can show you a good look at it, but it's got a little circuit board here, and it's actually got little tiny screws, and that's where your power attaches to. And then I just put a little ring terminal on it, and that goes straight to your positive on your battery. And then the other wire, it comes with a wire harness, but then that goes directly to your indicator here. So basically all you need is some ring terminals that are big enough to go on the terminal of your battery. You need some 8 or 10 gauge wire to make a short connection. And then you just attach your negative that would normally go to your battery. You attach it right here, and then it's gonna run through here, and then this side comes out and actually does attach to your battery. Your positive, you don't have to do anything with that. That connects to your battery like normal. And then again, you have you can use probably 16, 18 gauge wire for this. This is probably 16 gauge wire that I've used here. And like I said, put a ring terminal on, and then it just connects with the screw down here, and that powers your indicator. So basically how this works is you're gonna charge your battery completely full. Then you're going to set this to whatever amperage hour your battery is. So like this battery is 100 amps, so I'm going to set this to 100 amps when I hook it up. The negative, your power flow is going to be read through there. So anytime you're using any power, this is going to read it. Not only will it show you percentage, it'll show you exactly how many amp hours are left. So on this 100 amp hour battery, say I run for an hour full speed,
it's going to read around 70 amps left. And it'll tell me that, or it'll read, because it is 100 amp hour, it will also just tell me 70% left. Or I can also switch it and see exactly how many amps I'm drawing at that exact moment. So you can really test your motor and see how efficient it is on different speed levels.
I 100% recommend this product to anybody that's running a lithium battery on their autopilot, or any other kayak for that matter. You never want to be left out without any power, and with this you'll know exactly how much juice you have left. So I want to give a huge shout out to Dakota Lithium. Obviously I run all Dakota Lithium batteries. They make a great product, and I'm interested to see if this 135 amp battery will do the trick for me. So I appreciate you guys for watching. If you can, subscribe, follow me on my socials, Casey Reed Fishing on Instagram and on Facebook. And we're going to be doing some giveaways on some of the different social media platforms here soon. So please follow along, and thanks again for watching.